My name is Metin Firouz. I work as a faculty in the Department of Computer Science. My research interests span through graph theory, data mining, complex network, and big data. I particularly work on detecting communities in big data and ranking them. So technically what we do is we look through data and we use data science technique and artificial intelligence to extract meaningful and useful information. Some of the projects right now we have include brain anomaly detection, where we use a non-invasive model to extract data and record data from the brain to figure out if there is an anomaly including in this data, and we use network-centric approaches for that. Some other projects that we are having right now is predicting the market price for the loans from the bank for Fresno area. So the application of my research could be in any industry that deals with big data, like business, health, and also the agriculture industry. And we work through this with different techniques and sub-disciplines of artificial intelligence and data science. In my research group, students work in small groups. So we dedicate 2 to 3 students to each project, and the students get to learn to work with newest technology in data science. Through grants from Amazon and Google, we give them access to paid cloud services like Google Cloud Platform and Amazon Web Services, and they conduct studies using these paid services. This will equip them with skills that later on they will need in industry, if they are going to work in industry, and they will have advantages over the competitors that they have, because they already are familiar with the skills and techniques that they need. So this is one aspect of the knowledge that they are gaining. The other aspect would be, many of my students have presented in local, regional, national, and even international conferences and venues. They talk about their research, and they get the chance to connect with other students from other places, other professors, and also recruiters, which is a great opportunity. We equipped our Fresno students with these amazing opportunities, and we should be considering that usually these opportunities are only available in top schools in computer science, and we give these amazing opportunities to the students so that they can gain experience and learn from that. Aside from that, a couple of students that recently graduated and not even graduated from our lab have already got high-paying jobs in Bay Area, which is amazing. And each time we get the news, we are very happy with them, and they get the jobs with the skills that they learned during the classes or the lab experience that they had. One thing that should be mentioned is research doesn't always go the way that we were hoping to. So we don't always, or students don't always, find the result they were hoping in the hypothesis. The point is to enjoy the journey and learn the most from the experience they are gaining from each milestone. So that's the point. In my research approach, and in all of my research funding, we have deliverables that the students need to meet. We have goals weekly set, and we ask them to meet the goals. And the reason is all of my fundings are from national or industry agencies, which have some expectation for the research. So working in our lab means that a student will need to choose one of the projects to be involved in, and then they need to be committed to the deliverables of the project and learn from the step-by-step milestones that we have in the project. Meanwhile, they will have the freedom to choose their own paths, their own methods, and their own pace, or they can choose to swap between the projects. I was the first, or better to say, I was the only woman in my group to graduate from computer science undergrad. And for my master's degree, it happened again. There were no other female students, I was the only one, and I graduated as the top student, first student for the cohort. And I was really hoping to have some female company in my PhD program, but still, it happened again. I graduated the only female student in my PhD program, both in my lab and in my program. So I'm determined to not let that happen to my students. So in my lab, I always make sure that I attract and retain many female students, and I help them to have a group, to study together, to support each other, and to know that this field could belong to them too, and they can be successful.